Yeah, let me get that fucking cable out of
when
there.
You work in Let's Plays, occasionally technical difficulties may arise, and by occasionally I mean every single fucking time you start.
Every single fucking time.
So, you think you have everything prepared and ready to go.
Because you've done it the same way.
Exactly the same every time.
Every single time.
But then every time you start again, something new. There's a new terror that befalls you.
It lurks. It's so tight, though. That's what I don't get. It's
so
like,
tight.
It's as tight as it can possibly fucking be, but it still is just like, yeah, no, it doesn't mean anything.
Oh! Yeah, we got to turn the bass a little bit. There you go. Use the couch as a brace. That's like exactly where it was before.
Perfect. No, it wasn't. It was like way down there. It was way down there. In my dick, basically.
Dick basin.
My dick. God damn it! You beat me to it. Oh, I wanted to get dick basin.
Oh, fuck.
Did you get their fucking bow?
Yeah,
is
dude.
Is that what that is? That's tight so as hell.
Eventually, is that the one that shoots exploding arrows?
Yes.
Yeah. Fuck yeah.
So eventually, once I beat the boss, the optional boss that I missed, like a chode, then we'll show it off.
Tight titties.
But I gotta get to where I was first.
Okie doke.
Like a chode.
I think this is where
like a chode. Hey,
pretty sure this
like
is where we ended, right? Inside. Like
should I be feeling bad?
Inside.
Should I be feeling chode? It's kind of sad. I'm the laughing stock of the neighbor chode.
Inside. Inside the boss room. That's where we ended, right?
I don't fucking remember. Okay, before we do anything, I gotta tell you guys my awkward McDonald's story. So on the way here from work, I stopped at Mickey D's and I ordered my food. I get to the place where they give you your food.
The window.
Yeah. And then the lady, she handed me my pop and she was like, "All right, and then your food will be out in just a minute here." And as I'm grabbing the pop and like opening the straw, I go, "Okay, thank." And then I put the straw in and I'm like looking down and then I glance over and she's still there. Like I didn't finish my thing. So yeah. She thought I was going to say more stuff. But then I just like locked eyes with her. I was like, it was too late to add an S or a U at the end of that. So I was like, okay, and then she just closed the window. But since they were busy, there was a big wait, so we'd occasionally like look at each other from the closed window and just like meet eyes and like, God, that was weird. So, yeah, just K-thank. Good job.
K-thank.
I know how to speak words.
He's interrupting himself. Maybe he's going to say something else. Maybe he has a question. Yeah. I want to be attentive.
Yeah.
What is it, sir? What can I do for you?
Just watching me just fumble with my straw. And then I look over like, oh.
You guys lock eyes and it's just.
Anyway, that was awkward as fuck. Don't do that, guys.
All right, so anyway, welcome back to...
Welcome back to Lounge League. We don't say that enough. We don't say...
Oh, yeah. Lounge League.
Yeah, we're playing Ashes of Ariandel.
Dark Souls 3, DLC 1.
It is fucking... It just, like, straight up started hailing.
Is that what that is?
Yeah, your house is being pelted. I thought the outside was making popcorn.
Sweet. Well...
I was like, what the fuck?
Hopefully that doesn't result in a power outage.
God damn, left my fucking...
Last we left off, we totally beat the DLC. We weren't sure if we did.
It's cold as fuck.
But we beat the shit out of it and fought the major boss. But a big problem, Tom, you want to fill everybody in with what happened?
It's not a problem. It's just like, basically, I wanted...
Stuff.
No, we didn't forget anything.
We suck at seeing things.
We skipped an optional boss. First of all, and whilst exploring areas we had already explored, I stumbled upon the bonfire right before that boss, and I lit it.
Bonfire.
But I'm going to take the path down there as though I hadn't lit it, just so you guys, everybody who's watching this,
walkers on the path,
please watch this. can see how to get there or whatever.
And you know, guys saw us play this. Like, we were pretty thorough as far as exploration goes. Yeah. To the point of annoying me.
No, we missed. We actually missed a bunch of shit. Like, there's three Titanite slabs in this DLC.
Go, homie. That's a lot of Titanite slabs.
Before I go, I want to mention, once you beat the last boss, go up this ladder and talk to Ariamis.
What happens?
She has new dialogue. I already did it, so you
she
won't be
able to
see it.
She gives you her McDonald's toy collection. Do you guys remember when Apollo 13 came out?
I do. And they had the Pogs.
Hardee's had
we're dumb.
Spaceship. And you could get a different piece of the spaceship.
Woo!
Your, like, kids' meal or whatever toy.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And they had Pogs.
Yeah, it was tight.
I miss Pogs.
Pogs were so cool.
Yeah.
I had, like, a giant tube to collect all my Pogs.
Pogs were tight. See, I fucking knew you could walk on those fucking tree fucking roots.
Yeah, you were right. I was rewatching, what is it, the third episode where I go past those, the one that came out today. And I was like, yep, that's, you can see it. Basically, right as soon as you get up the hill, you can see where
that bitch.
Where you have to go.
Look at that bitch.
Fuck him.
I don't think I'm going to need to do this.
I think he's just hanging out. Just going to get an easy fucking kill. Fuck you, Edward.
Get
around some sticks. What happened there? You had, like, crazy iframe.
Me?
Yeah, I thought he lunged at you, and it just went right through you.
I thought he lunged at you.
I don't know. I thought he missed.
Oh, my butt.
Whoa. The
sweet butt juices.
That's the last thing we need.
Buttress of Windsor.
Oh, ho, ho. Who's this?
How's it going?
That's a first.
Oh, that's gonna fuck. Is it gonna explode? It's not exploding.
It's a spear.
Listen, horny. Thinking about a couple things to say to you.
Showing. Growing. Man, I'd like to place my hand upon that fucking sexy ass and squeeze.
And squeeze.
Take off your blouse and your underpants.
And take a lick. Cause hear me, NKG, come naked out of the side hatch.
Okay, too much song.
Perfume.
That was Tenacious incense. D. If that song now sounds cool, grooving. Listen to Tenacious D.
Put on a killer 70s groove. Bow, bow. A funky groove to fuck to. Bow, bow. A funky groove to fuck to. All right, now we go. Because that,
can you imagine?
That part, it gets way too good to stop. Oh, jeez.
Can you imagine? Oh!
Yep. Tom was
is
distracted.
That a fucking crab?
Tom was distracted.
It is a fucking
crab.
Is
that a fucking
pike?
Fuck those
long
crabs.
Spear with a very long hilt. Designed for long range thrusting. Has the longest range of the non-projectile weapons, but is very length. Makes it unwieldy in certain situations.
Skill charge! Can you imagine being one of the parents of the kids that starred in Goosebumps and meeting Jack Black and being like, oh, yeah, you're going to be working with my kid. And then, you like, for some reason, you don't know what Tenacious D is. And then...
You Google it.
Yeah, and then you listen to Tenacious D, like, offset as your kid is acting with Jack Black. And you're just hearing shit like that. And you're just like...
he's saying.
And you're like, no, no!
Wouldn't
no!
that be worse for the School of Rock kids, though, being they're much younger?
Yeah, that too.
The shit is gonna piss me off. Falls slowly. You can't hold
falling
it the whole time, Billy.
Slowly.
I can do what I want.
That's not a viable solution.
Wow, the fucking bridge, like, respawns.
Everything respawns in Dark Souls.
You're the one who you bought my Tama mic stand, didn't you?
Oh yeah.
Why don't you bring that over? This one's jank.
Is Tomas using it?
Fuck, I don't know. No.
Billy, you have several.
No, the
mic
one that I sold you
place.
Is like a really nice.
A
like,
lot of them aren't mine.
One.
So. Like really? Like, is he gonna notice if it's not there?
She might.
She? Oh, okay. I see.
Fuck this guy. I don't even
that
care
makes
about
a difference.
Yeah, I'm in a band with Audrey. She.
Oh,
made...
shit. I fucked
oh,
up.
Shit,
oh,
no,
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 man, put
no.
It.
Ah, fucking.
I got
ice
too antsy.
Ice egg sacks.
Okay.
Do you
I
need
think,
to turn the mic now
I
that it's
think,
been fucked up?
No, I think we're good. MXL 990 is facing my tits.
And we're back! Tom, this time Tom is not going to fall to
this
his
This is our
death.
First time playing this.
I am
Guys,
not
what
making
is this
that
game?
Guarantee.
I've
I'm going to try.
This game before.
We're fucking 9 episodes in and we can't fucking go down a simple cliff face.
I'm going to try one more time and then I'm just going to bonfire down there.
Maybe if you fucking just leap really hard, then you'll land safely.
I'll break through the ice, shatter my legs, and then maybe survive.
You got to do a superhero landing. That's the problem. You're falling like a regular person would, a non-superhero.
Use that shield and do like they do in Willow and just fucking sled.
Oh, jeez, I almost fucking just down the fucking derped off that.
Derping off.
If I'm herping, I'm derping.
Dank son Akira. Akira.
I wish it said dank.
Dank souls.
Dank Yharnam Nugs.
Dank Yharnam Nugs. God damn.
Did we make that joke?
No. I wish.
No. I got it from somewhere.
I remember the first time I heard that you said that in the fucking car. You said it, and it didn't make any sense because you hadn't played Bloodborne like at all at that point, I don't think. And you were like, dark, dank Yharnam Nugs. And I was just like, I almost shit my pants in the back seat.
They're smoking the dank there.
Mm.
What exactly is dank, like, as far as drugs are concerned?
It means really good.
Because I know that in a basement, that's not necessarily
stinky.
Good.
Yeah, it's not a good thing.
Stinky and moist. It's referring to the how much like the bud stinks, and usually the stinkier
the
bud, the better.
Stinks. Your butt stinks,
saying, it's
bro.
It's like a common rule.
Let me tell you,
stink ass butt.
Common guideline.
Going to a fucking Incubus show. Incubus fans have the dankest fucking weed. Oh my god.
I bet a lot of people would dispute that. Oh geez, stop with the fire, man. I'm good on it.
I don't care who's...
I hear Shakira concerts have the dankest weed.
Alright, I made it.
Nice, good job doing that simple task, Tom.
I went and saw Deftones and Incubus last year in Illinois, and holy fuck.
God damn, that was a year ago?
Yeah, over a year ago. It was last July.
I have no concept of time whatsoever anymore.
It just keeps going
faster. It just slips away from you.
It does.
Yeah.
Oh, he's alive.
Do you guys like Rush?
He's fucking alive.
I like the idea of Rush.
Oh, damn. All right.
I like some of their songs, but I don't just, like, actively listen to Rush.
Yeah, same. Fair enough.
Holy fuck!
Oh, there's two of them.
Oh, mother of God!
I'm not fighting two crabs.
So, the reason I ask is because what we were just talking about reminded me of a Rush song that I really like called Time Stand Still. Are you guys familiar?
Nope.
It's pretty tight.
Can you sing it for me?
No.
Okay. No.
I'm not a good singer.
No, I'm not
doing
it.
Day warrior, mean
but you're an alright singer.
Thanks, man. There's also a female vocalist in that song.
I'm not remotely a good singer, and I sing all the time, every episode.
Yeah. I get really self-conscious, though.
Nobody cares.
I know, but, well, I do, obviously.
I don't think anyone would care if you were a good singer.
That's true.
Wow, that was brutal.
Because you suck as a person so
much.
That was
like...
Yeah, that's
really
true,
mean
too.
Thing to say.
In retrospect, I'd like
Jesus!
To...
Jesus!
Well, I've never seen one get
that was
that
the
mad.
Shriekiest bitch I've ever seen.
Yeah, she was upset.
She's still really upset.
She's fucking miffed. You uprooted her.
Damn.
From ice.
Snap freeze. I'd like to take a moment to revisit one of our earlier episodes. Sorry, Ellen. I don't know why I said that.
Yeah, you were a dick.
You guys have talked about it so many times since we did that episode, and I still have no idea what you said.
That is episode 4, and he was talking about the fucking,
Oh, so we're gonna talk about it again?
Yeah, the fleshy bird creatures, and he was like, hey, Tom, doesn't that kind of look like Ellen or something like that? And you were like, at first you were like, yeah, because you didn't register what he said, and then you were like, wait, no, that's really mean. And
yep, and then, I'm a garbage person, yeah, my bad.
And then I was killing on Billy, comparing him to garbage.
Yep, that makes a bunch of sense.
Alright, I want to point something out for people
Homeward Bone!
Who might watch this or will be watching this or whatever. This ladder isn't here initially. If you noticed when I was coming down this path, this ladder was not here.
Did you raise
so
your
you
insight?
You have to go down the left path and kill that lady and pick up Snap Freeze, and then this ladder drops.
Weird. That's... You have to travel down the left-hand path. Isn't that a satanic thing?
That's a very uncomfortably open area around that ladder.
And a lot of people were saying how the Metal Gear Solid, like, Snake Eater music should play right here or whatever.
Oh, nice.
You're just, like,
yeah,
climbing up that ladder
yeah,
forever.
That was dope. That played, like, a couple songs, I think. Like, and it cycled through them.
Redonkulous.
Then there was Metal Gear Solid 4. The fight with the Revolver Ocelot is just playing, like, every song in the series because it's so fucking long.
They're like, yeah, just do the hits.
Eventually, they're like, to the point they're just like, God, we're so old! And they're just, like, taking 20 seconds to make one punch, and they punch each other's hands.
And then they take their Metamucil.
Yeah, they take a poo break.
Oh, man, that's a really good... that game is amazing, though.
Yeah, it is.
I still haven't even come close to beating Phantom Pain.
Same here.
You're missing out on the crucial...
I know the whole story of it or whatever. One day I realized that I wasn't going to beat it anytime soon. I was like, fuck it, I'm just going to look up the story.
Did you see the scene where Quiet talks?
No.
Thanks, man.
Hey, it came out fucking way long ago now.
Oh, wait. Oh, why'd I do that? Why did I do that?
You get so flippy eager.
I'm so stupid. Fuck it.
I'm so stupid. When in doubt, reference this if you need to know how to get there. And just do what Tom does and already have been there. And well, then teleport there when you can't get there. Point, oh, wait, because you can't, because you have to get there first.
No, he did. I did it. I got all the way there. Were you not? Do you just not pay attention to something?
Not at all. Sometimes I'm just like in my own little place.
Fills in blanks as he sees. Because
I went all the way down the tree roots and walked over to this bonfire and sat down at it as though I were lighting it. And then I went off into the path.
You pretended to light it.
Yeah, well, no. I mean, I had to sit down at it anyway.
Light this, motherfucker.
Why are you so hateful right now?
I'm just mad at how awkward that McDonald's was. I'm just coming at you with
love. Thank.
Thank. Okay, thank. Okay, thank.
So.
Okay, thank, bye. Duo.
Like, you have to go out of your way to... Affinity. You would think you'd have to go out of your way to say, okay, thank, like...
Purposefully.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, there was a strong K at the end of that.
I'm not looking fucking forward to thanks. This shit.
So this is a boss right here?
Yeah.
And you have not faced him yet?
No.
Flowers. Cool. Winter flowers.
What if they're just way harder?
I am anticipating having a tough time.
Okay.
I'm so excited. I did not look it up on purpose because I wanted to be surprised as to
who it was. I mean, I had to look it up to find out where it was.
I used to have a porpoise.
Oh. Champion's Grave Tender. Chicken tenders.
Like Champion Gundyr?
That guy doesn't look so tough. He already fought some of these wolves. He missed you. He's not that cool.
He missed you.
Kind of avoiding him right now.
Oh, God. With the wolvies. The wolvies.
La, 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 la.
Can we talk about how using Johnny Cash's version of Hurt is cheating in a trailer?
Hey, it conveyed emotion. Okay?
I know. It made me cry. It makes me feel things. It's cheating. You could play that over, like, fucking Harold and Kumar go to White Castle's trailer, and I just tear the fuck up.
What if I become, and that fucking weird-looking dude with the hot wife is there? I heard everything you said.
Oh, yeah. That's, what's his face from Law and Order?
Christopher Maloney?
Yes. And Gene. Oh, my God.
Oh, shit!
Oh, my God, how did you not get hit?
I don't know, man.
That was fucking insane.
Absolute pure luck.
Did he warg into the wolf?
Oh.
Tried to dodge.
Ooh, got that dank shoulder.
Once again, probably should have gotten hit right there.
Holy torpedo.
This is bringing it full circle back to the beginning of this playthrough.
Oh, something I was going to do.
It's the same wolf.
I wanted to look up.
Did you guys realize that?
No.
It's the same wolf.
Is it really?
It's way bigger.
It looks way bigger.
You know, if you didn't note, you didn't notice when I first fought it, it disappeared at half health.
Oh, that's why it went away so quick. I remember I was like, wait a minute, how did you kill it so quickly?
It looks bigger, though.
It does look bigger. It looks bigger.
The same wolf, man.
Maybe he got bigger. Maybe he got bigger and is still the same wolf.
He ate more souls and got bigger.
It's true. It's probably true. I'm just gonna spam you. Because I don't care.
They're fucking going to town on the strings right
now.
Holy
eyeballs.
Oh, mamma jamma. He's got the cyclops eye.
Oh, shit.
Well.
You almost had it.
And then he went turbo mode.
The frostbitten came up after you died. Frostbitten!
My body was frostbitten.
Well, what am I gonna do with that?
My dead, lifeless body.
is frozen.
At least it's really close to a bonfire. Like, really fucking close.
Spider shield. A shield bearing large etching of a spider.
Like, at least this close. Shields of this
style. Oh.
So, I was going to look up Rinoa's dog from Final Fantasy VIII because I mentioned him.
Do you want me to paste a picture of Rinoa's dog?
You don't have to.
Future Demos, if you feel like it, put a picture of Rinoa's dog.
I think it's called Angelo. Angelo Rush.
Angelo.
That was the name of the move where the dog, like, torpedoes, like the wolf is doing. It was one of Rinoa's, Rinoa's limit breaks. How do you guys pronounce her name?
I never played it enough.
You never played 8?
I didn't play it enough.
Fuck!
I mentioned that I only played a little bit and got stuck and stopped.
Right on.
Right outside the school.
A lot of people hate on 8, and I get it.
I don't know. I liked it.
I really liked 8.
I enjoyed the shit out of what
time I did. We covered this topic ad nauseum in Diablo. So if you want to hear our opinions about Final Fantasy games, just go back and
check that shit out.
Check out Diablo.
Listen to me get fucked up beyond all reason on fucking whiskey.
Tom is like me and thoroughly enjoys 10.
Yep.
It's my favorite.
That is
Sin!
Cool. Say what you want about it, man. It's a good game.
That is cool.
I almost spoiled it.
I've learned to accept it, and it's okay.
It's still played like a Final Fantasy, like one of the old style.
Totally. Ones. You're not wrong. I don't think I liked any of the characters. Maybe Kamari. I think I liked Kamari.
Giant cat dude.
Yeah, giant cat dude. Always gonna win in my book. And then I was severely disappointed because he was the blue mage of the group, and I'm just like, ah.
It'd be exhausting to play the score to this game.
You think?
Like during the boss fights, like there's a point in this fight where it's just going.
Oh yeah, they get nuts.
Blade here goes. And shit.
Oh, he fucking knew what was
he's
up.
Like, oh yeah, you want to hide behind that pillar, man?
He's like, fuck your pillar hiding.
Where you
shit.
Going? Where you going?
Where you at?
Fuck
it. Where you going, number 52?
Yeah. I'm surprised they're not just summoning a dick ton of wolves.
Yeah. Well, he's not at half health yet.
I mean, he already does the bullshit at half health. I don't need more wolves.
Did he? Oh, okay.
He's got the red eyes. Jesus, fool! What's up, buddy?
Oh, he's fucking sliding.
God damn, he's got the ice skates on. Great wolf on ice. Oh.
Shit, watch out!
Where'd he go? What the fucking pedo fuck? Jesus.
What does that mean? What does that mean? Are you slow poisoned?
It's frostbite bar build up.
Frostbite build up.
Damn! Defrostbite!
It like made you deaf.
Like
for a
second. When am I supposed to fucking attack him? Like
right?
When?
This is nuts.
Get him now.
Get him now.
Do it now.
It's always two attacks. And it's like, oh, hit him once.
Fuck,
frost breath bullshit.
Fuck.
Now I'm gonna do some teleport tornado
fuck.
At you.
Teleport
four
tornado.
Times or whatever.
Now you got this.
Forever.
He's basically dead. Get him! Whoa!
Careful. Here it comes. Yeah.
Here I go.
Yeah! Ow!
That's it.
Did that say Voldemort?
Is that the end of the DLC?
It's the last boss, yeah. Last boss we have to beat.
Is there like no cutscene to tell you that the DLC is over, or do you just fucking wander
we
around?
Already beat the we last boss, Tomas.
I know, but there was no absolution. It was just like, I'm
actually,
dead!
There actually is a lot explained.
There were cones!
You just don't know enough about Dark Souls to pick up on it. Like, I was reading a lore thread earlier, and there's a lot of connections to be made in this DLC. Like, a lot.
A lot. All right. So, what do you guys want to do? Do you want to,
Do you want to see my itinerary?
Or what?
Do you want to suck my balls?
Itinerary?
I kind of wanted to show off some of the, like, weapons and stuff from this DLC.
Oh, yeah.
And I think this would be a pretty cool place to do it in, because it's, like, the bottom of it.
And it's safe.
And also, the painted world of Ariandel and Ariamis are the same place.
Fucking tits.
Yeah. Yeah.
Velka confirmed.
It's pretty dope.
I've been saying it.
Are you researching over there, Billy, when you're on your phone while we're recording?
You literally just put your phone down. As well.
I was checking the time.
Were you? Yeah. Maybe that's what I was doing. You presumptuous ass hat.
I'll presumptuous your ass hat.
Okay.
Presume to assume that you are a fuck.
You might have noticed, if you've been watching the whole thing, that I'm wearing a new set of armor. And this is a set of armor from one of the invader NPCs that we fought at one point. The Wilhelm guy.
Oh, tight.
This is his armor set. I actually really like it. I think it's
that
awesome.
That dude was fucking boss.
It kind of seems a little like Shadow of the Colossus, because you're super top billowy.
Yeah, I like it. Anyway, cool. Some cool weapons. You can get some crow quills from those one guys. It's pretty tight. It's got a rapier in the right hand.
Oh, you have both of their weapons?
And then, no, this is just one weapon.
I know, you have one of each of the dude's weapons. Because one dude had the double crow claws. And the other guy had a rapier.
The other guy had a rapier and throwing knives. Yeah, this is just one weapon, Tomas.
I know.
It's okay. One guy's weapon. I don't get it. What are you not understanding?
Can you throw those?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
I was going to get to that, but you were interrupting me.
Shut up, Tom. this is a team.
Shut up, Tom. Now show me stuff.
So anyway, the weapon art is that. That's what the weapon art. And it's cool if you can lock on to people, you can, like, control the direction you jump. So it can be used, like, I think it's meant to be used close range, because the daggers don't do shit for damage unless you're right up in their face and you hit them with all of them. And then, obviously, the L1, like, combines both of them.
Whoa.
Into a pretty sweet, it's an awesome attack. So that's those.
And you get those from killing those dudes?
No. I tried for a while. Most of the things you get, most of the weapons are drops. They're not, like, they don't come from people. They're actually just out in the world somewhere.
Oh.
This is probably my favorite, like, regular weapon from this DLC, because it is just the Karthus Curved Sword, the most overpowered weapon in the game. That one that you said was really cool, Tomas.
Yeah.
It's ridiculous. It's a curved sword. Curved swords are really good right now. The only drawback to this one, which is those guys we were fighting in the first area or whatever, with mm-hmm. that shoot or spit fire, mm-hmm. and also have the spears.
Mm-hmm. The Vikings.
Yeah, one type of enemy uses these swords, the really flaily guys that are just like, ah, just swinging at you like crazy. Its weapon art is absolutely insane. Like, watch this.
Damn.
And that not only does that have, like, if you're locked onto somebody, it doesn't matter if they're rolling around you or whatever. You'll hit them. And this move right here, it also acts as a guard break. And no matter what shield they're using, no matter how much stability they have, no matter how much stamina they have, if you hit them with that, they're going to get guard broken.
Cool. Give me that and I'll play the whole fucking game.
It's broken. It's not fair. I bet it gets nerfed sometime in the future.
How hard was it to find it?
It's actually at the very bottom. Not at the very bottom, but, like, on one of the last branches on the way down here.
Oh, so not hard.
So not that hard, no. You kind of have to... It's a little bit out of
the
way.
Well, I guess you did fall several times.
So you have to balance, yeah. That was actually the first time, like, on camera was the first time that I have fallen off.
You weren't even talking when it happened.
I know.
Just...
I just got this from this fight, so I haven't used it. I haven't used it yet. But it's apparently one of the best weapons in the game right now, and I can see myself liking it a lot.
Oh, that's cool. Yeah. Fuck yeah.
I don't have any Estus, otherwise you would have seen something cool there.
Oh! Gonna get you!
It has a really sweet running attack, too. Watch this shit. It's just, like, got a lot of range compared to most other running attacks.
Brad Pitt from Troy.
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool. When I play Soul Calibur, that's the style of fighting I generally play as. I play as the chick who has the sword and shield. It's very satisfying.
Yeah.
If we ever do Soul Calibur, you guys can watch me beat the shit out of everybody with that character. We should play
some Soul Calibur.
That's true. I will sit out that one.
No, Billy, you were playing because you get mad and it's funny.
Nah, I'll sit that one out.
No, you're not going to sit
it's not good for me, for my spirit.
Nobody cares.
If only I had one more.
Yeah, I know. You've made it abundantly clear that nobody gives a fuck about anything about me. If you didn't
burst a blood vessel playing Nidhogg, I think you'll be okay playing Soul Calibur. Right.
You were there.
And then
I was there.
I think I did bust one.
My absolute favorite weapon from this DLC.
So you got it from
Frida.
From Frida.
Frido.
You have to exchange her soul for it. Frido so you Baggins. Have to choose between this or a spell, I think.
Fuck, I would always weapons. Always weapons.
But the thing about it is, it's weapon art puts you in a sweet stance. Like, watch this shit.
Ooh.
And then all you can do, you can't, like, roll or do air sprint.
You just walk.
You
coolly.
Can only walk like
you just
this.
Walk like a badass.
But it gives you two different moves. I don't know if I'll be able to do the one that actually uses. Yeah. Normally, it, like, when you do that, it puts this huge, like, arc of frost on the ground. Like she does.
Nice.
And then it explodes after like 3 seconds. But I can still do the regular attack animations.
Phlebas!
And they're awesome.
Phlebas is online! Does Phlebas watch our videos?
Damn!
No. Phlebas is one of my main dudes from
Destiny.
My Destiny clan, though.
You should make him watch the videos.
He's my homie. Shout out to Phlebas.
Hi, Phlebas.
I don't know, man. He's
like in A Clockwork Orange.
He's older. He's not interested.
Eyelids open. Older than us?
And our shit, yeah. He's like in his 40s.
Like 52. Damn. Who the fuck was that? Get the fuck out of my yard!
Alright, so now what I want to do is I want to try to figure out... I don't know how it works exactly. But, there's a way to do this arena.
Are we just going to make one long episode?
No. How long does the arena take, Tom?
I have no idea, man.
Alright, tune in next time. Hopefully it's an interesting episode where Tom tries to fucking arena something or whatever.
Yeah! It's going to be tight!
Yeah.
But that's essentially Ashes of Ariandel. And hopefully you watched us instead of somebody else.
But it's cool if you watch somebody else, too. I mean, just watch everybody.
Especially us.
Especially us.
Because we provide the content that everyone sees.
I don't know what that means, but, you know, that's cool, too.
I mean, I told my weird McDonald's story. You don't get that everywhere.
That's very true.
K-Thank, bye!
K-Thank, bye!